The way it got started was my husband, back in the year 2000, loved candles. He just never was really happy with the way they performed. And Bill being Bill, did some research and found out a way to make his own. But I didn't meet Bill till 2006. And so he wooed me with candles and flowers. And it was some of the candles he'd made years ago. It burned wonderful. It smelled fantastic. And I thought, this could be more. All of our products are natural. It's our own special soy blend. There are no carcinogens in any of our products. A lot of people have issues, you know, allergy or allergic reactions. They don't have the same issues with ours. Now, again, I'm not making a medical claim here, but these particular individuals are able to use our products. In our candles and actually several of our products, we customize at no additional charge. For example, we participate a lot with benefits, and this particular label had a nice little photo, so the photos do work well on the labels as well. We also have what we call our lid disc, and this is where you can have a photo or actually even something that you may want to say a special message inside of the lid. We have our incense. We also have candle vases. This is where we pour our product into these, so when the candle's gone, you have a beautiful bud vase. We use local artists for our ceramics. This is an artist from Illinois. This is also another style, and this is our glass artist, and she's actually from St. Charles. It's Becker. We also have our melts. This particular warmer is made by an artist in Independence, Missouri. Something we do a little bit different at Scent From Home is that we put cute little items in the lids. This happens to be one for a baby. This is a favorite, and this is in our Caribbean cooler candle. It can be in any candle, but this is your seashells and your sunglasses. And then this particular one that Cornerstone Mortgage uses, it's actually an apple-scented candle, and he put the little miniature apples in here because he gives one of these away at every home closing, and he felt like that symbolized home with the apples. Well, you know, a lot of people don't realize that the label on the bottom of a candle is not just the warning label or the ingredients. This actually tells you how to properly burn a candle. Most importantly is your first burn. And the first burn, you want to make sure you have enough time to burn it long enough that there's going to be a solid liquid pool across the entire surface of the candle. That will cause your candle then to burn evenly all the way down. If you don't do that, you'll get something called tunneling, where it just goes right down the middle. I know we've all experienced that. One other thing that a lot of people complain about is sooting. Paraffin candles tend to have a tendency to do that regardless. Soy is a lot less apt, but it's because most people don't keep their wicks trimmed. You need to keep them to a quarter of an inch. And after you've burned a candle a long time, most of us don't want to blow the candle out. We're enjoying, you know, the nice fragrance. But you'll notice something that looks like a mushroom, and it is actually called mushrooming. And that's where the actual wick itself is burning on itself. That's causing the sooting. So if you will keep your wick clean, burn your first burn long enough to create a complete liquid pool, then you're going to be good. Your candle's going to burn nice and even. You can find Scent From Home products online, also on Facebook, and at a number of local merchants.